Illinois University Chapter, Reverend Father Ronald Canada and Father Andy Roman. Join us in the singing of the entrance hymn.
Thank you. forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Redemption, and he will redeem Israel from all their iniquities. You, O Lord, are our iniquities forgiven.
Please don't stand for the first before the last.
You were told
as reminded that you are now a Christian and therefore a child of God. You were taught prayers. Your parents brought you to church during Sundays, and little by little, you learned what a Christian is and should be. But most of all, you were taught to follow and to imitate Jesus, who did or sowed the goodness around him everywhere at all times. Now today, you receive the sacrament of confirmation. A good number of you are now 12 years old. Now you know and you are aware of what is happening this morning in this ceremony. And more especially, you are aware and you know what you are receiving in this sacrament. The Church prescribes that this sacrament of confirmation should be received by a baptized person who is old enough to accept and to perform the responsibility or responsibilities he or she receives, because now he can be aware and can understand the responsibility given to him or to her. This is the reason why the age of 12 years old is required or prescribed by the Church. And this is the reason why you are now qualified to receive confirmation. Because now you understand that God has chosen each one of you for a special assignment. Starting today, God assigns each of you to do something special for Him. When the bishop anoints your forehead with the oil of Christ, he tells you, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. At that moment, you receive the Holy Spirit, and he tells you that he chooses you to work for him. And what is the work that God assigns to you? St. John in his Gospel says that the Lord told his disciples, quote, I command you to go out and to bear fruit, fruit that will last, unquote. It means, my dear young friends, you have to try to spread goodness around you. That is what to bear fruit means. That people who meet you, people who see you, people who listen to you, will recognize you as a good person. Because you are kind, you are respectful, helpful, you are honest, you can be trusted, you can forgive, and you also know how to ask for forgiveness. In other words, you make people around you happy, and you can inspire them because of your good example to become good like you. That is what confirmation does to you. The Holy Spirit will always be with you, but you have to do your part. It means you can become good boys and good girls. You can become young people who can inspire others to do good. But you will still experience temptations. Temptations like laziness, anger and revenge. Temptations like greed and selfishness. Temptations to be unkind, to be proud and haughty. That is why you have to be always on guard. To be on guard means to be conscious that whether alone or with people around you looking at you, God is present there all the time. He sees you. He knows what you think, what your plans are. He knows what you feel here inside. So you have to discipline your own service. You have to learn to say yes to what is good, and to say no to what is bad and sinful. This is difficult, but you can do it, because the Holy Spirit is with you starting today. So starting today, learn by doing your things how to make the Holy Spirit your true friend in prayer. When you wake up in the morning, as you lie down to bed, lead me, invite him to make his presence felt by you, and to make you see his presence in people you meet, so that you can do something good at all times, no matter how difficult it is. To the parents and sponsors, to our priests and brothers, let us pray for these children of yours. And the best prayer we can offer for them is the good Christian life and example that we can give them at home, wherever we are, wherever we do. Let us teach them that we know and we are ready to choose good and to do good at all times. God bless us all. I ask our candidates to please stand. Our families will now make the renewal of their baptismal vows and promises. Please answer in a loud and clear voice. Do you reject Satan and all his works and all his empty promises?
I do.
Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth? Do you believe in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, was crucified, died, and was buried, rose from the dead, and is now seated at the right hand of the Father?
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord and Giver of life, who came to the apostles at Pentecost and comes to you today, and the sacrament of confirmation?
I do.
This is our faith. This is the faith of the Church. We are proud to profess it in Christ Jesus our Lord.
Amen.
My dear friends, in baptism God our Father gave the new birth of eternal life to His chosen sons and daughters. Let us pray to our Father that He will pour out the Holy Spirit to strengthen His sons and daughters with His gifts and anoint them to be more like Christ, the Son of God. All-powerful God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, by water of the Holy Spirit, you freed these candidates from sin. Send your Holy Spirit upon them to be their helper and guide. Give them the spirit of wisdom, knowledge, understanding, the spirit of right judgment, courage, and the spirit of reverence and wonder and awe. We ask this through Christ. Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Anointing the fatherless with wisdom.
Peace be with you.
peace be with you. Christian, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you.
Thank you.
Papa, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Please be with us. Friends, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Please be with me. Joseph, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Please be with me. Gabriel Ramon, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Please be with me. Mary, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Please be with me. Today, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Please be with me.
Thank you.
seek with the gift of the Holy Spirit, peace be with you. Be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit, peace be with you.
Thank you. My dear friends, let us be one in prayer with God, as we are one in love, and the Spirit has poured into our hearts. That our response be, merciful Father, hear us.
Merciful Father, hear us.
Let us pray for the parents and grandparents who have brought these newly confirmed boys and girls to receive God's gift to them, His Holy Spirit. May they, by word and example, continue to encourage them to lead Christ-like lives. Let us pray with them.
Merciful Father, hear us.
Heavenly Father, we offer you our sons and daughters, upon whom your divine Son has bestowed today the completion of the sacrament of baptism. Make them true witnesses of Jesus and help them develop genuine concern for their fellow man, especially for the less fortunate and for those in need. Let us pray the Lord.
Merciful Father, hear us.
Heavenly Father, grant a special blessing today to our parents, whom we owe so much, and to our principal and teachers who have made and continue to make so many sacrifices in order to help us attain Christian maturity. Let us pray to the Lord.
Pray, my dear sisters and brothers, that our sacrifice be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the grace and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his church.
Lord, we celebrate the memorial of our redemption and wish your Son won for us the gift of the Holy Spirit. Accept our offerings and send us your Holy Spirit to make us all like Christ in bearing witness to the world. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
Father, all powerful and ever living God, we do well always and everywhere to give you thanks through Jesus Christ our Lord. He ascended above all to heaven, and from his throne at your right hand, poured into the hearts of your accepted children the Holy Spirit of your promise. We steadfast love, we sing your unending hymns of praise. We join the host of heaven in their triumphant song as we sing.
Mystery of faith.
Father, calling to mind the death your Son endured for our salvation, his glorious resurrection and ascension into heaven, and ready to greet him when he comes again, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look the favor of your church's offering and see the victim whose death has reconciled us to yourself. Grant that we who are nearest by his body and blood may be filled with his Holy Spirit and become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make us an everlasting gift to you and enable us to share in the inheritance of your saints. With Mary, the Virgin Mother of God, with the apostles and the martyrs, and all your saints, let us constant intercession with your life, O God.
Lord, by the sacrifice which has made our peace with you, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Strengthen in faith and love, we build your church on earth, the servant of Benedict XVI, our bishop is in all the bishops, to the clergy, and in our people your Son has came for you. Father, hear the prayers of the community of God and give before you. In mercy and love deny for your children, whatever they may be. Welcome into your kingdom, our departed brothers and sisters, and all who have this world in your friendship. We hope to enjoy forever the vision of your glory, through Christ our Lord, and whom all good things come.
Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. Now let us offer each other this sign of peace. Help those you have anointed by your Spirit, and fed with the body and blood of your Son. Support them through every trial, and by their words of love, build up the church in holiness and joy. Grant this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. A specific prayer has a message of encouragement. We would like to thank the following for making this great seventh proclamation possible. Reverend Vicente Navarra, D.D., our officiating brother. Reverend Father Robert Quimano, our university chaplain, and Reverend Father Randy Duraman. Brother Ray Sublido, FSC, our university president chancellor. Brother Arian Lopez, FSC. Mrs. Dimas, our principal. Mrs. Carmen Renato, vice principal for the lower grades. Our lay ministers, readers, petition prayer leaders and offerers, high school choir and band members and acolytes, Sir Del Limpo and Ms. Ana Salvador, grade 7 homeroom advisors, Sir Donilon, Sir Mark, and Teacher Rafi, grade 7 CL teachers, while our brother Ariane, Ms. Andre Gabriel, and Ms. Yuki Simpson, Ms. Linda Ferrer, Titi and Jennifer, grade 7 conference parents and sponsors, Sir Dennis Tan and the security force. Please all rise.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Please bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. God our Father made you His children by water and the Holy Spirit. May He bless you and watch over you with His love.
Amen.
Jesus Christ, Son of God, promised that the Spirit of truth will be with His church forever. May He bless you and give you courage in professing the true faith.
Amen.
The Holy Spirit came down from the disciples and set their hearts on fire with love. May He bless you, keep you one in faith and love, and bring you the joy of God's kingdom.
Amen.
And may the Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. We have offered the Eucharist.
Thanks be to God.
Saint John Baptist, let us have us.
Pray for us.
Give Jesus in our hearts. Also for their coverage this morning.
I would like to take this opportunity to inform the parents that this afternoon we request your students or your children to go back, to come back to their classroom for their reach out activity. As a faith response of our confirmants to their confirmation, we facilitated this reach out activity in the afternoon in the different venues. 7A, Holy Infant Nursery in Sumang. 7B, Missionaries of Charity in Banago. And 7C, St. Vincent's Home.